It's a When Calls the Heart inspired recipe. Guess what inspired the recipe? The Mountie mustache. That's right. It's Nathan's Mostaccioli. What's Mostaccioli? Mustache in Italian. So stay tuned. Click that button and subscribe, and click the bell and the word all for notifications. So this is the mustaccioli, and it's called mustaccioli because of the way it's cut on an angle so that the pasta resembles little mustaches. First, before I begin, let me show you my little handy dandy burner that I purchased. I will link it in the description. It comes from Amazon. So I could cook right here. So anyway, I have a pot of water boiling and it's getting ready for the mustaccioli, and I will walk you through that in a minute. But first, let's talk about the base of the sauce. So Nathan, we have to admit, is sweet. So we have a sweet sausage crumble. It's a pound and I'm gonna put it in there. I added about 2 teaspoons of olive oil, and we are going to put the crumbled sausage in here and let it brown. And then it's gonna have all these yummy little toasty bits, and then I'll show you what we're gonna do with that. So why do I put sweet sausage in there? Well, first of all, I love sausage, but also because Nathan's sweet. He's a sweet guy. He's very much sweet when he's with Allie. And I love when it's Christmas time and he is so thoughtful and he thinks up that adorable charm bracelet because his sister had one, so he gets one for her. And then he knows her so well, he puts a little fly on there for fishing and a book because she loves to read, and then he can add to it. I mean, that's a sweet thing to do. So sweet sausage it is. So we're gonna let that brown and get all crumbly, and I'll show that to you, and then I'll tell you what's the next step.
Add a pound of mustaccioli to a rolling boil of salted water. Once it is al dente, you can rinse and then allow to sit back into the pot while the sauce is cooking. Once the crumbled sausage has browned, you can remove it with a slotted spoon, put it in a bowl, and set it to the side.
Okay, so we are going to add our base. So I have one medium sweet onion and one clove of garlic. We're gonna put that directly into all that good stuff and let it saute. And once it sautés, we're going to deglaze all that goodness with either a cup of chicken stock, or it could also be vegetable stock. I reduced the heat, and now I'm going to add to the sautéed onions or garlic the stock. And it deglazes the pan, and it takes all those delicious bits and give it a little swirl, scraping the bottom of the pan. And you can use a wooden spatula, but you can also use one of those silicone spatulas. That works great too. And give it a whirl, give it a few minutes to bring the heat back up. And now we're gonna talk about the next ingredients. So I'm gonna hit it with a little bit of salt. It's good to salt it along the way, just a little bit, because we are gonna add cheese. So as this is coming up to bring the temperature up, we are going to add some chopped tomatoes, 2 cups of chopped tomatoes. And you want to buy whatever is in season. So I'm a South Jersey girl. We have the most gorgeous in July, August, early September, gorgeous Jersey tomatoes. But of course, this is not, you know, the summertime. So you want to get whatever is in season, whatever is at your local grocery store, wherever it is that you shop. Maybe you are, you know, down under and you are having now the warm weather, so you'll have access to beautiful fresh tomatoes. These are cocktail tomatoes. You can get Campari tomatoes, but I got these and it's so fitting because guess what? They're a product of Canada. Mm-hmm. And you know, Mountie Nathan is a Canadian, as is Kevin McGarry. So anyway, I wanted to show you what they were like. They were really beautiful. I checked them out. Believe it or not, I got them at Target. So they're on a vine and you can pluck them off They're gorgeous. And chop them up, so it's 2 cups. Now I'm putting tomato in there because that's the Italian thing to do, but also, and it tastes delicious together, because it brings a brightness to the sauce. You can use a crushed tomato, it becomes too thick. You want this to be like chunky and hunky because Mountie Nathan, especially with that mustache, is quite the hunk. So I'm gonna put them in here and they bring a brightness, and we have to admit, you know, Mountie Nathan is a very successful Mountie and he is quite bright. How about when we first had the opportunity to meet him, how he solved that case and figured it out? Let's have a little flashback right here.
He's very observant. He examines and analyzes, collects his clues, pays attention to his surroundings, which he is not familiar with yet, but he seems to know exactly what he's doing because he's a very good Mountie. He's very bright.
Okay, so you want it to cook down, give it a couple stirs. And then while it's cooking down and the tomato is going to release more liquid, which makes more of the sauce, we're going to put some spinach in here. So this is steam in a bag spinach, but I use it for anything. You don't have to steam in the bag. I'm gonna use like half of, I opened it up and it compacted down, half of the bag. And this is also going to wilt down and also help make a sauce. And I love the spinach with the tomato. The flavor is amazing. But what I also want to talk about is, you know, spinach, strength, muscles. What about those muscles that Mountie Nathan has, okay? Can we talk about him and chopping the wood? How about that? Okay. Also, riding the horse as fast as he does. That takes some great strength, yep, and skills. So we got the brightness and we have the strength. Spinach and tomato. And it's going to cook down and it'll take a few minutes and I will show you what that will look like when it's ready. It's bubbling. It really does not need to cook long. It sort of melts and wilts down and creates a sauce right away. This is a fresh sauce. It's not one that has to cook for hours. So now what we're going to do is we're going to put the sausage back into the sauce. Let me show you what the sauce looks like again. Looks good. Stir. Let it all the flavors meld and marry. Smell-o-vision, smell-o-vision. Let's think about Mountie Nate. What would he smell like? Like the woods and spicy? Ooh, speaking of spicy. First, before we get to spicy, let's go with cheesy. So I have some Italian cheese here. It's a blend of Asiago and Parmesan cheese. You put in whatever you like. But we have to admit that Mountie Nate, he is a bit cheesy, especially when he's with Allie telling her his dad jokes like right here.
We've met a lot of nice people just about everywhere at the station.
Well, yeah, but remember last year at Fort Simpson, their idea of Christmas morning was listening to a bunch of boring speeches in the mess hall.
At least there was a lot of fellas in red suits. I'll see you later, okay?
Okay, we're gonna sprinkle that in. Seems like a lot, but it's not because we're putting a whole pound of pasta with this pound of sausage. You wanna give that a good mix? Oh my goodness, it looks so good. And then once I add it to the pot of pasta and give it a good like toss, I'll display it and we are going to drizzle on top something that is hot and spicy because let's face it, you know that Mountie Nate is hot and spicy, okay? Just a little drizzle because a little goes a long way. It is olive oil that has been infused with red chili peppers. If you don't have them, like the red chili flakes, you could very easily drizzle a little bit of olive oil over it and sprinkle some flakes, but we know he is hot and spicy. Especially when he's chopping wood. Did I already talk about him chopping wood? I can't help it. It's one of my favorite pictures of him. Let's look at that again. And a few others. Okay, we're gonna add the sauce, which is like, oh my gosh, look at that, to the pot of Mostaccioli, the mustaches. because this is Mountie Nate's mustache. Look, so cute, so cute. Okay, we're gonna add it in. And give it a toss. It looks so good. Yummy, yummy, yummy. It feeds many. Don't forget there's a pound of pasta plus a pound of crumbled sausage in here. Oh, look at the dripping of, oh gosh, of the sauce, the juiciness. Oops, made a little mess. I am not Gustav. Oh my goodness, tastes so good. And then a little drizzle, the hot and spicy. A little goes a long way. Right on top. And then we feast. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh my goodness. Mountie mustache. Nathan's Mountie mustache. Delicious. Delicious. Let's see. Sweet, a little spice, the freshness, it's good. Like Mountie Nathan, he's good. I am so excited for season 9, and I'm sure you are too. So if you try this, let me know in the comments what you think. Even if you don't like it, I like to hear the feedback. Normally I have a test kitchen full of people, and I don't this time. So I'm interested, because it's something we kind of make in our family anyway. I'm interested to see what you think. I'm sure many of you are not of Italian heritage. I am, if you don't already know. And it's something we make, and I thought it would be fun. I did not add any extra ingredients. It's what we normally use. And I didn't realize that all along I was making, you know, Nathan's mustache the whole time. All right, you have a good one. Bye. Oh my gosh.